ओम शांति। गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एन एक्सपीरियंस हाउ वी कैन बी हैप्पी, हाउ वी कैन ब्रिंग हैप्पीनेस इन आवर लाइफ। What we can do to bring peace and happiness in our life. All we have to do is to be ourselves. We have to have good feeling and good thoughts. Good thoughts and feelings where do we experience the feelings in our heart, which is part of our mind, in our mind? And where do we create thoughts? In our mind. So mind is our lab where we can create our happiness. So let us learn a little bit about our mind so that we can know how we can be happy. So the first thing that we have to know, that who we are. I am a soul in this body. The soul and the body, these are two separate beings together. We work together. Just like how the body has different organs, same way the soul has three subtle organs: the mind, the intellect, and the memory, also known as sanskar. And it is the mind where we feel and where we think. This mind is a subtle organ. It connects through the brain to the body. So it is separate from the brain. It is more subtle than the brain. And we are separate from our mind, intellect, and memory. We, the soul. So the center point of the whole drama is I, the soul, who is beyond even the one that is creating the thought. So I, the soul, I use my mind, my intellect, to create. And the mind connect with the brain. And through the brain, work with body to create reality. So let us learn a little bit about ourselves. Who actually we are as a soul. And we are learning this because we want happiness in our life. We want peace in our life. And by knowing this, we can easily bring happiness in our life. So the easiest way to describe ourselves is in five or six different areas. First is my name. What is my name? I, the soul, assume a body, or I enter a body and assume its name. And then when I leave that body and enter another body, I have a different name. So every time I enter another body, I have a different name. I, the soul, am the same, but I have different names according to the body that I take. I, the soul, am eternal. What is my form? How do I look? I'm formless. And for the purpose of understanding who I am, I see myself as a point of light, a shining point, very tiny. In fact, I am not even that point, an invisible being, like an energy, like the electricity that flows through different electrical equipments. That energy generate different manifestations. Similarly, I, the soul, when I enter the body of five elements, I manifest my power through the body. I manifest peace through the body. So my form is a point. What is my place? Where do I come from? Where do I reside? I come from a faraway place, a place called the land of peace, the land of nirvana, because I'm a subtle being. I'm beyond the five elements. I belong to the world that is beyond the five elements. And that includes everything that we can see and perceive. That also includes the sky. So I come from a place that is not even within the sky. And when I come and live in this world, where do I reside? I reside at the center point of my world. My immediate world is my body, my mind, my intellect. And I take the center stage of the body, which is the center of the forehead, which is where the whole control of the body is. A place between the master gland, the pituitary gland, and the hypothalamus. But obviously you can't dissect and and see the soul. But that's where I take the control. That's where I connect the subtle and the gross. That is the connection point between invisible and visible, intangible and tangible. And such a point has to be there for the world drama to occur, for the energy to manifest, for the soul to manifest. So that's my place, the center of the forehead. In relation to the time, what is my identity? What is my identity in relation to the time? I'm an eternal being. I don't have origin. I don't have an end. So I'm one of the three entities that are eternal. God, I the soul, and the matter. These three entities are eternal. I'm one of them. When I enter the body that I create, it disintegrates. So the body is perishable. But the matter of which the body is made is not perishable. It is eternal. The five elements, eternal. I, the soul, eternal. What is my function? What do I do? What is my role? My role is to bring life, bring story, bring drama in this lifeless world. Because when I, the soul, leave the body is dead. There is no life. And when I am in the body, there is drama, there is story. So I am one of the main actors in my drama. One of the main actors. And the main actor, the Supreme Soul. The director, the Supreme Soul. But I am one of the ones who is very important. I come into this drama to express myself and to experience. That is my role. And the purpose is to feel my inner qualities, which are pure happiness, peace, love. I feel that. I'm an embodiment of love. But it's joy to experience that love. And that's what I do when I enter into the world drama. And lastly, how do I do it? Whatever I do as a soul in this world, how? I create thoughts. Because as a soul, as a point, I don't have organs like body does. I create thoughts. These are deep level thoughts, not the thoughts that originate in the brain, but very deep and very powerful thoughts. And these thoughts, they result 100%, they result into what is needed, what my intention is. So if I create a thought of peace, guaranteed, it will create peace. But I, the soul, have to create that thought. If that thought is originating at a superficial level, it's a weaker thought. So the answer, how I can create happiness, is to be in my true form, is to know that I am a soul. And as a soul, I create a thought of peace. I create a thought of happiness. And that happiness guaranteed becomes a reality in my life. What are my, and finally, what are my qualities? What is my nature? My nature, my most basic nature, is peace and purity. Purity means unmixed with anything other than I, the soul. Like pure gold, there is no alloy mixed. So if my consciousness, my awareness is I am the soul, there is no alloy of body consciousness. And high level of purity leads to purest of the pure result. When I am the pure soul, I only have peace. That is my true reality. Happiness and love is superficial. When I am a point of light, I am peaceful. That is it. Just peace. But when I enter the body, then I assume three other characteristics, which are also my very close nature. And that is love, happiness, and truth. Because in the body, I interact with the other souls, with the five elements. And how do I interact? I use love. I use happiness. I use the truth. The truth is, I'm a soul. I interact with others as a soul. So as a pure being, I interact and I create a beautiful world because I have loveful thoughts for others. I have truth in my relations. I have happiness. I'm full with happiness as I interact. There is no intention to cause harm. In fact, I don't know the word harm or sorrow. I only know what is happiness. Then, as a soul, when I progress along the timeline, I assume more superficial characteristics. And these are power and balance. When I become more aware that I'm a body, then I have to use the powers. When there is no body consciousness, there is no need for the powers. In the body conscious stage, I use my powers, the powers to judge, the powers to discern, the power to tolerate, the power to face, the power to cooperate. The power to accommodate. And I use balance. Balance between being a body, being a soul within the body, and being the soul. So the balance between being body consciousness and soul conscious. Through this balance, through these powers, I continue to live happily. I continue to bring peace and harmony in my world. As I further progress, I become more and more body conscious. I begin to forget that I am a soul. Then I begin to create thoughts related to the body. And these are inferior thoughts. I begin to create thoughts that are wasteful. And even negative thoughts. And the result is sorrow, pain, suffering, hatred, anger, peacelessness, unhappiness, weakness. I no longer am able to create powerful thoughts. My thoughts are weak. Fortunately, the time comes, which is now, when I realize the knowledge that I am a soul. And through this knowledge, I begin to become soul conscious again. I begin to bring the balance between power and love. The balance between being soul and body conscious. And I move towards my original stage again, where I am very happy and powerful, where I can create pure and elevated thoughts, and I can contribute happiness to the world. So with these few thoughts, let us meditate. Let us go within. Become aware of your true identity. I am a soul in this body. And bring your attention to the center of your forehead. Visualize yourself as a point of light. I am a soul. A peaceful point of light. Fill your awareness with this peace. I'm radiating peace all around me. The peace is dissolving all situations by flowing through them. My mind is creating peaceful thoughts. The heavy feelings are dissolved. I constantly radiate peace all around. Creating peaceful environment. A peaceful halo all around me. which keeps growing, keeps radiating out. Into my family, my relations, into the world, all the drama is becoming silent. The peaceful waves reach to the end of the universe, merging with the peace of my home, the land of peace, where the ocean of the peace my father is. I realize that I am a being of peace who has emerged as a stream from that ocean. I constantly radiate peace. And within the peace is hidden love, and within that love is hidden that happiness. I radiate this happiness in my world. I have now learned how to create happiness by simply being myself.